Hello everyone, welcome back to Win Games for another episode of our DOTS tutorial series. In the last episode, we have seen how to use the baking workflow to define the behavior of our entities into the scene. We have made two cubes that follow the path defined by four game objects. Those game objects are baking-only entities that will not be part of the runtime world. And we have defined a move system using the SystemBase and Entities.ForEach syntax to make the cube follow our path. And today, we will see how we can make this system using the ISystem interface and the idiomatic for each syntax. Let's get to it. We will create the idiomatic for each just below the Entities.ForEach to compare the two syntax. First, we make a normal C# for each. And then we declare the variable we will use in our behavior. The transform, the path index, the path, and the speed. And finally, we use the SystemAPI syntax to query the component that will be assigned to those variables. We also need to declare the access pattern to those components. For the transform aspect, the access pattern is defined within the aspect. For the next path index, we will need to use the read and write access pattern, so you can add the ref RW syntax to get access in read and write. And for the speed, we will need the read-only access, so we will use the ref RO syntax to get access in read-only mode. Finally, the dynamic buffer is a special case, and for now, it will only be accessible using the read and write permissions. Finally, we can define the body of our for each expression by copy-pasting the existing entities for each code and updating the necessary access variable. We can comment the entities for each and save the file. Go back to the editor to make sure that everything works as expected. As you can see, the cube still moves. If we go back to the code editor to look at the differences between the entities for each syntax and the idiomatic for each syntax, you will have noticed that the way we declare the component we need for the behavior are different. But that's not the only difference. The entities for each had the ability to execute the code in a multi-threaded manner, using the schedule or schedule parallel methods, whereas the idiomatic for each only run code on the main thread. That means that if we want to run code in a multi-threaded way now, we will need to use an ijob entity or ijob chunk, which we'll see in future videos. The idiomatic for each also has the ability to be nested, meaning that we can put a for each inside a for each like in normal C#. Which is not the case of the entities for each syntax. Some of you may have noticed that the entities for each also add a filter on the render bound using the withAll method. For the idiomatic for each, you can do the exact same filtering using the exact same method on the SystemAPI query. One final difference between the entities for each and the idiomatic for each syntax. By default, the entities for each syntax was bursted, meaning that it used the burst compiler to get the code to the machine. The idiomatic for each is not bursted by default. To burst it, we will have to use the ISystem interface instead of the SystemBase class. Before seeing how to do that, if you like the video so far, please hit the like button, it helps a lot. Thank you. Let's make a new system using the ISystem interface. Below your existing system, create a new partial struct. And make it implement the ISystem interface. As you can see, the interface defines three methods by default: on create, on destroy, and on update. We can remove the exceptions that are spawned in all the methods, and we can copy the idiomatic for each from the system above. To access the delta time, we will need to use the SystemAPI once again. We can save the file and go back to the Unity editor to check that everything works fine. Our cube move, and we now have two systems, the move ISystem, which handles our two entities, and our previous system, which no longer contains any code and doesn't handle any entities. If you want to play around, you can go back to your code editor, uncomment the entities for each, save the file, and enter play mode again. You may notice that your cubes are moving twice as fast. That's because we are applying the transformation twice, once in the move system and once in the move I system. If we were to disable one of the two systems, the cube would move slower. If we disable both systems, the cube no longer moves. And by reactivating one of the systems, the cube moves again. Great, but our idiomatic for each is still not bursted. For it to be bursted, we need to define the burst compile attribute on both the method and the system, otherwise the burst compiler would take too much time to figure out which method should be bursted. If you want to practice before the next video, you can try to rewrite the baking system using the ISystem interface and the idiomatic for each syntax. After trying by yourself, you can look at the answer at the end of the video or in the GitHub repository linked in the description below. Thank you for watching. If you like this content, please hit the like button and share it with your friends. And as usual, if you have any question or remark, let me know in the comments. See you in the next video.